He lived alone in that house, surrounded by the great forest of whose gloom and silence he seemed a part. For no one had ever known him to smile or speak a needless word. His simple wants were supplied by the sale or barter of skins of wild animals in the river town, for not a thing did he grow upon the land. A few acres of ground immediately about the house had once been cleared of its trees, but the man's zeal for agriculture had burned with a failing flame. The little house had a single door, and to the side, a window. The latter, however, was boarded up. No one knew why, nor could anyone remember a time when it was not. I fancy there are few persons living today who know the secret of that window. But I am one, as in due time you shall hear. Years ago, it seems, he had had a wife. Of her charms of mind and person, tradition is silent. But of their affection and happiness, there is abundant assurance in every added day of the man's widowed life. For what but the magnetism of a blessed memory could have chained that venturesome spirit to a lot like that? Anna.
Thank you. Thank you.